I think research is the thing that attracted me to science, because before that, I didn't have such an interest. And experiments, doing experiments and trying to find something that was not predicted. I think that's the most interesting thing in science. Reading and keeping eyes open, I guess. And curiosity is something that, you know, it's built in. And I think I always was curious, and I will be always, I guess. Probably Coentanoji. Coentanoji, we went in the 70s, we went to the Collège de France to his lectures, and he really excited me a lot. I think he was extremely rigorous and at the same time extremely open. I think that the two qualities, I think, are really inspired me. Yeah, by spreading right ideas. And I think it's difficult, but that's the job. Try and try again, I guess. If there is a reason, and then we have to find the reason. So we have to think about it and then try again. Maybe you did something wrong. I mean, in the experiment, it's very easy to do things wrong. And I think just try again, because it's very rare that things worked in the first time. I have one experiment back in 79 that worked really the first time. But this is usually not the case. And we have to try again. Big failure. Okay, this happens all the time. I mean, big failure in as a scientist, you know, as experimentalist, is something very easy to achieve. The important thing is to understand why this happens, and just try, I mean, to fix the problem. That's the way I react, at least. Most of the time, okay, you find two or three things which could have gone wrong, and you fix one after the other, and usually that works. I tried not to, but sometimes I guess it happens. Not the last few years, because I was really established in this attosecond business, and I feel this is home. But in the past, perhaps it happened although the way professional research works, it's you really do things that you're supposed to do. And I think I always felt, you know, at home with that kind of work. When you are not exactly sure what experiments to do, and you try one, and it's not that great, and then you really think of what I'm doing here. Maybe this is not my where I should be. But yeah, I remember where when before I guess in the 70s, I went for a postdoc, a sort of postdoc in Los Angeles, but before that I was doing experiments that were not working very well, and I was wondering if this is really the work I should do. Fortunately, this changed with the time. Yeah, try to understand what you do. That is, at least in the as far as possible, try to do theory also with experiment. And not just experiment, but I've known a number of people who are, wonderful scientists and physicists, and they have, qualities that I'm afraid I don't have. I would here think about Harm Müller, my old colleague from Amsterdam and from the FOM Institute, who has, absolutely wonderful qualities and is both an extraordinary theoretician and is fantastic in the lab too. So yeah, is the example I would cite for anyone who wants to do science. Okay. It's difficult to define a single word, but I would say precision, and be aware of things. I remember once we had a glass setup in the lab, and it had to be heated to outgas and to purify the atmosphere inside. And once we were heating that thing, and I forgot about it. And we were for lunch. And when we came back, that thing was melting. It was horrible. And I was, it was all my fault, and this is not being aware of things. And yeah, from that time, I think I've tried to be aware of things. Well, now I have some free time. That's right. I read most of the time. That's what I do. I mean, literature is my thing. Oh, American. novels and mostly fiction. Yeah, for example, Gluck, Louis Gluck. Probably because there's a lot of things in the literature that could make me a better person. I don't think it has made me a better scientist, though. Yeah, because it's something necessary. You cannot avoid that. That's part of the job.